Hello everybody, this is Fernando for the latest Aliens and UFOs news video. Well, I thought I would mix in another update associated with this Area 51 raid that's again going to happen on September 20th. Real quick though, I just wanted to mention this will probably be my last update for a little while, only because now that more days have passed and this thing is going even more viral, unfortunately, it's just gone up on the cheese factor when it comes to who's joining in. So when you have stuff involving celebrities, when you have songs now dedicated to it, major brands that are now being part of it, it's just lost its esteem. So when it comes to that point where even grandmas and uncles are talking about this kind of stuff, you know, it's not really interesting anymore, to me at least, and I imagine that's going to happen with others as well. So this will probably be the last update for a little while, at least until something big occurs between now and September 20th, but still some good interesting info to showcase here when it comes to the latest set of updates. And I'll go into more detail in a minute as to why I mean it's jumped the shark and it's gone into that cheese factor, and you'll see why, and I hope you agree with me on this. But first, let's go ahead and let's talk about the newest totals associated with the Area 51 raid. So now, as you see here, almost 2 million people apparently are now going to this event. As always, just take this with a grain of salt, a little tongue-in-cheek, because no way 2 million people will be there. Subtract a bunch of zeros, and you'll probably get just a couple of hundred. There's definitely going to be, I imagine, a lot of news stations, now that this thing has gone so viral, that are going to be there, whether it's from major news or even from internet news. All these bloggers, all these vloggers as well, they'll all be out there just seeing what'll happen. And as always, there'll be onlookers, tourists, enthusiasts, people that'll be out there too, just to be there, just to say that they can see what's occurring. But yes, as far as the newest local totals, that's what we have going on so far. And then there's been yet another statement associated from the government, and I'll include the link for it below here. And this was something that I found there on Yahoo, and in this case, it's two statements from the Air Force base that actually manages that location. One was a spokesperson that says that they're aware of this Facebook post and that the Nevada Test and Training Range is an area where the Air Force tests and trains combat aircraft, but as a matter of practice, we do not discuss specific security measures, but any attempt to illegally access military installations or military training areas is dangerous. So again, they're stressing up front right there, that spokesperson, that dealing with this stuff is not for the lighthearted. Do not take this like as a joke, even though it is a joke. Do not attempt to cross anything over into that location. And it continues with the Staff Sergeant Joshua Kleinholz, who says, any attempt to illegally access the area is highly discouraged. And then just like any military installation, there are different levels of security depending on what has been detected. And obviously the degree of response may escalate depending on the perceived threat. So right there, those are all the words needed to tell you what'll happen if someone truly, or people do truly, try to do anything after. Like if they're just standing there looking around, then the perceived threat will be less, and so there's no escalation. But the minute that people start moving over, and then that factor kicks in where others see people moving over and they decide to join in, then that's when I imagine that things will really, really pick up. Will it even get to that level? No, because I'll discuss more in a minute about what I think will happen. But the next thing I wanted to talk about is why this is jumping the shark. Well, take a look at this. Now you have celebrities that are jumping in on this Area 51 raid. Like you have, in this case, Guy Fieri, a famous cook. I see his face a lot there in Las Vegas when I travel. I think he has like several restaurants there. But even he has chimed in stating he's going to have some radioactive ribs ready for anybody that, or any alien that happens to get out of that place. Or I think even if any of the ongoers there too. And then you have Bud Light, who has decided to join in as well. First stating that no, they're not going to do anything as far as it. They'll be the first ones to officially not have any beer, and then all of a sudden they decided, let's go ahead and let's post a commemorative beer associated with this event. And so you'll see the picture of it here. I love the little slogan at the end, we come in peace, when it comes to this Bud Light Alien Edition stuff. Then you also have songs that are being done by rappers, also with Billy Ray Cyrus in them too. I found a YouTube video for it. So this is the point now where it's getting cheesy. It's getting definitely where when your uncles and grandmas are all joining in on this and they're laughing it up, and then, you know, they're sharing it on Facebook with others. It's getting, you know, it's no longer fun like anymore. It's no longer interesting. It was something more of a, for us enthusiasts on the aliens and UFO side, and this was going to be quite fascinating to see what happens. But now this is something else. Like whenever you have major celebrities, all we need now is something like the Kardashians or even other comments from shock jocks or anybody else out there to finally just reach another point. So, and that's why I'm going to give this a little rest, because when we get to that point where we have celebrities from all various levels now chiming in on this, and you have major news stations now just putting this in a lighthearted manner, which it is in the first place, you know, it's sarcasm, it's a joke as far as this event and the way it was started. But still, whenever you have like so many other news channels talking about this and poking fun at it, this is just not something that I'm just going to cover anymore too much going forward. And that leads to the next thing too. What I really think is going to happen is this. So as far as the date, September 20th, yes, that's still there, but I imagine that a week or two before that, there's going to be something happening on the road leading up to that place. I don't know, somebody might want to point this out if I'm wrong, but I don't know if that's necessarily a public road, that long dirt road that leads up to the installation base, that leads up to the entry point, the one that I've been to, the one that apparently everyone will be there on September 20th. That dirt road, if I'm not mistaken, is not a public road. Like, it's a private road. And anybody that travels there is pretty much allowed to now as a tourist. There's nothing stopping you from doing that. But I imagine that about 2 weeks leading up to this event, that dirt road is probably going to be closed. Like, if truly the Air Force base there or the U.S. government feels that out of public safety, they're going to stop this once and for all, in terms of it getting out of hand, they're going to close that road but leave the highway that attaches itself to that road completely open. You see what I mean? Like, the private road will be closed, but the highway, the long highway that leads up to Rachel, Nevada and all that location will not be closed, but that's the closest that you'll get. And that's what I think will happen. And there's precedence for this, because I remember a couple years back, everyone, with Occupy Wall Street, there was that park that was taken over for a couple of weeks by all the protesters. And then when the protesters announced that there was going to be another big date happening soon, I think it was like an anniversary date involving once again taking over the park, I remember it was the city of New York or somebody from that department decided to block off that park before that date. And then that way it never happened. No one was able to get any kind of encampments placed, and it just died off on its own. So I totally imagine that's what's going to occur here. That long dirt road is going to be blocked off, and the highway leading up to it, because it's truly a public road, will be left open. And that's where everyone is going to be able to just hang around, for lack of a better term, during this September 20th event. It'll be interesting to see if my theory proves right, but I have a good feeling that that's exactly what's going to occur. And then cut to a couple weeks later, and then you'll have everything reopened once the event is just long gone and something else is trending on Facebook and on YouTube or even on the Twitter world. And then when that happens, then the road will be reopened. And that's unfortunate though for the tours that take to that location, because that's their bread and butter. Like, that's essentially going to be the only reason why people go out there. As I mentioned, I've been on that tour, I think it's coming up on 2.5 years now since I've taken it, and it was a really, really great tour. You get to go to the two entrances, one in the front, one in the back, and I highly recommend it if you still have a chance to go see it. But with this tour facing these closures, as I think it will happen, then that'll really impact them. And of course, regular tourists who just take the tours on, you know, just go on their own, then that's where that's going to be bad news for them too. But what do you guys think as far as the latest updates? Has this jumped jumped the shark? Is the Area 51 raid now officially cheesy? Is everyone going to get tired of it soon? And if so, will it just die down? Or will it still happen sometime around September 20th? And if so, will it be something big? Or will the roads be blocked off? Let me know what your theories are. And yes, I will hold off on any more updates unless something big happens. If something does occur and it's worthy enough at least to talk about on any kind of videos, then I'll definitely do that here. But yes, please post your comments below, share your thoughts. Love to hear what you guys think. And as always, thank you for your continued support and viewership. All right, everyone, take care. Bye.